Morning and welcome back. Is my screen visible? Yes. Now please go to open a new. If you go to file, like yesterday, go and type Google Colab, and then you will get a window. And under file, you select a new notebook. Select a new notebook, name the file as say internship day two or whatever name you want to give. Internship day two, and please type in these two commands. That is, we have seen yesterday import NumPy as NP, import NumPy as NP, so which was having all libraries for computing sinusoidal functions, the inverse sine, converting from degree to radian, radian to degree, the logarithm, and all. So we were able to do a lot of mathematical operations using the NumPy library. And typing NumPy takes some time, so we shorten it as NP. So NumPy library is important, but in our whole program, instead of typing every time NumPy, we can simply type NP. Similarly, today we are going to do plotting of functions. Like morning we did plotting. So today we are going to plot functions. No problem, Yamuna. Yes. Import matplotlib.py plot as plt. So this is the matplotlib.py plot as plt. Please check the spelling, type correctly. And then instead of this is a library which will help us to plot functions, which will help us to plot functions. And instead of typing every time such a big command, we will always use the word plt. Like how np was representing numpy, like that plt will represent matplotlib.py plot. Yes. If you have done it, and then after typing in this, just run the cell. Just run the cell. Just run it. And if you have completed, please let me know. Please type in the message done. Please type in the message done. Yes. Yes. We'll wait for some more. I hope we have 50 participants. Yes. We'll wait some more because the whole lab is based on having, unless these two are lines are many of our codes will not execute. Yes. Yes. Yes, very good, very good, very good. So nice to have active participation. Yes, so now we will start plotting some functions as yes, so let's take the so let's have a new cell and what shall we plot first? Let's plot a sine function. Now before going to the plot, we need to define time. We need to define time because then only I can plot sine of t, cos t, etc. So let us define time. Now let's take t as np dot linspace say 0 comma 2 comma 10 or say 11. 0 comma 2 comma 11. Or say 9. Yes, 0 comma 2 comma 9. Please run this and tell me what you're getting and try to explain what you're getting. Run this line np dot linspace 0 comma 2 comma 9. 2 comma 9. And then explain what we are getting. Just run it and see whether it works. Oh, sorry. I need to put print t, and then only we will be able to see the result. Can someone explain what has happened in this code? What has happened in this code? Are you getting it? 0 comma 2 comma 9. let me make it say another one. If I want to do t equal to np dot linspace 0, 0, 1, 5. Yes, very good. We got time interval. Yes, we have another answer which says we got 9 values between 0 and 2. Yes, and are linearly spaced. Similarly, you have another function which is log space. We will use the log space for when we plot the frequency response later on. Right now, it is linear space. It's a time function. So just try. Let us say -2, -2, -2, 2, 2, 9, and see if it works. So if I want to describe this command, how do I describe it? Np dot linspace is a start, end, and a number of values that we want, a starting time or anything. It could be time, it could be x, it could be anything. A start, an end, and a number. A start, end, and a number. So normally we like to define time in this manner, and because I want to have a plot of a function. What was the other command we saw? This is method one. This is to define time. This is one method. This is same method one. I can have another method. What we saw yesterday. What did we see yesterday? The method two. Np dot a range. 0. Let us say -2, 2, 2. 0.5. Let's run this and say print t. I wanted two also to come. Say 2.1. If I do this, this is what I get. This is another method of defining time using a range. This is np dot a range. Here again we have start, end. What should I put the third value as? Start, end, and what's the third parameter? The step size. And remember, the end works a little minus. It does not work for these. So these are two methods of representing time. Sometimes we will find linspace convenient. Sometimes we find a range convenient. So we should be comfortable in both. So now let's try to take a function. Let's take first example. Example is say to plot the exponential function. The exponential function. Let us define time. Time as say np dot linspace say 0, 0 to 2. The advantage with linspace is even the last value is executed. Whereas in a range, what happens? The last term does not. It comes out of the loop before the last term. Let us say 0, comma say 5, and how many values I want? Let us say 50 values. Let us take this way, and let me just make it 5 values. And what is my xt? X of t is, class is going on, np dot exp of let us say I have another constant a, a equal to let us say 0.5 e to the power of minus a into t. So I define my time as linearly spaced 0 to 5, and I'm taking only 5 values, and then I want a, and then I'm computing x of t. So I let me print xt. Let us try to print xt and see what we get. This is what we get. Here we had a as 0.5. Instead of a as 0.5, suppose say I make a as 1, and let us say I make this as 6, and let me run it and see what I get. Are you able to recollect these values? When we plotted by hand, e to the power of 0 was a 1, then e power minus 1 was 0.36, then e power minus 2 was 0.35. So if you want, we can also print time, print t, and then print t times x of t. So are you able to recollect? We did by hand the plotting of the exponential function, e power minus t. Of course, here I can change a, let me put as a as 1. I can put any other value, but this is just to verify for small numbers whether we are getting the same answer. Same answer. Have you done it? If you have done it, please message in done. So we are just trying to compute by hand, manually, what we did in the class. Yes. Yes, one Shashanka has done. Any more have got this answer? Any more have completed it? Okay. Yes, can I proceed? Yes. Okay, so then I assume that most of you have done it. So let's proceed. Let's plot the same exponential function. Now we just saw the values. Let us try to plot it. Let us try to plot. Plot the exponential function. T is equal to np dot linspace say 0 to 5. Now since I'm plotting, I can let me give large number of values, and let us say a equal to say 1, and let us say xt equal to np dot exp of minus at. So same thing. Now only thing is, now we are going to plot. See the command plt dot plot. What we want on the x-axis, we want t. On the y-axis, we want xt. On the x-axis, I want t, and on the y-axis, you can use floating values I will answer that question. The Tuskeer has asked, you can't use the last term as, I'll show that. One second, let's answer the question. NP t equal to NP dot dot linspace linspace 0.25 to 1.5, and let us say 10 values, and let us say print t. It works, but the last number is number of terms. You can't give 10.5. If I put the number of terms as 10.5, it will give error. It gives error because the third term in this space is number of terms. Number of terms has to be integer. The first start and end can be float. So is that clear? So this will work. Starting and ending values can be float numbers, but the third term is number, so that has to be an integer. Yes, good. It is good to ask questions. And yes, so now try this. I am defining time t as a linearly spaced in the interval 0 to 5 and 50 values, because I'm plotting, so I can have large number of values. Or you want, once again, you want to have less number only. Let us have the same number, 6. And a is being 1, and x of t is np dot exponential e power minus at, and plt dot plot. So let plot, what does plot take? The x axis is the t and the y axis is an xt. So let's run it and see whether we are getting the result. We should get that exponentially decaying function. What's the reason? A space before t is not a problem. Oh, okay. Thank you. Yes. Thank you. Yes, thank you. Yes, so here we have the exponential function, and that we are plotting in the interval 0 to 5. I have put 50 values, and then I get manually we were computing it for every instant of time. So if I put 6, then if I run it, it will not be smooth. So you see, it had computed one value here, one value here, and here, and so on. You want to see the values, you can simply put in single quotes x, so then you will get the points. We will get the points separately. We'll get the points, and so you want the point, you want the marker as well as the line, you put this. You will get the plot as well as the line. So now here we have the plot, and if you want a smoother curve, instead of having 6 values, we can have some more values, let us say 20 values. So then what will happen is we will have a smooth plot. So did you follow this? What is x doing? Every point that it is computing, it is putting an x, and if I don't put this dash, it will give me only the values without the continuous line. See, I get it plots all the points. If you want the line as well, you can put the line, and then it will also mark the values and it will show the plot. If you don't put anything also, it will still work. It will give the plot. Now let us try to, if I want to read the values, I need to be clear. So say plt dot grid. Plt dot grid, it will put the whole curve. You'll be able to read the value, so that you have this x and y axis or a grid being present in the plot. Let us put, are you following? PLT dot x label. X label in single quotes, you put time t. And what is my PLT dot y label? what is y exponential of minus 80. You want to put a title, plt dot title. Exponential function, and then if we run, now what happens? We have a plot. We have the title for the plot. We are having time t, and this is e power minus 80, and of course we had put a as this. Have everyone done it? Yes. Anyone want me to repeat any command? So it is t comma xt. Yes. Now what we'll do is in the next So now next example, we will plot, let us say, two exponential functions on the same plot. So t equal to np dot linspace, let us say 0 to 5, and let us say I continue with 50 values. Now I'm going to have let us say a1 as 1, and let us say a2 as 0.3, and I have, let us say, x1t as np dot exp minus a1 into t, while x2t is np dot exp minus a2 into t. And let's try to plot both of them. Have you done this much? A1 and A2, and let's plot both of them. PLT dot plot T comma X1T and PLT dot plot T comma X2T. Please run this code and see whether you are getting two curves. And also let me know if both the curves are in the same color or different colors. If both the curves are in same color or in different colors. We are plotting two exponential functions on the same graph we want to get. One is e power minus t, and the other is e power minus 0.3t. And please run it and tell me what is it you're getting. Yes. And now so we don't know which plot is which one. So let's put let's run it and see what we get. We have got two exponential functions, and both are of different color. And it's not come down to zero, so let me change my time to say 10. Let me run the same program. I'm trying to plot it for 0 to 10, and I have got it. Now I do not know which curve belongs to which signal, and hence one option is to put it here. Label what is this function? First one is e to the power of minus t. In the second case, our signal is label e to the power of minus 0.3t. And you want this legend to be displayed. So you simply type, and it's always good to have the grid on. So now let us run it. And you see now By default, it will position the legend at some suitable location. And you know that the blue line corresponds to e power minus t, and the orange color corresponds to e power minus 0.3t. Have you done this? Yes, yes, yes. I hope everyone has been able to do. You put a legend, so inside single quotes, whatever label you want. Whatever label you want. We'll wait for some more answer, some more to get it right. Please confirm if you are completed. I try the different values of A1 and A2. Yes. Yes. Very good. Can we proceed? Can we proceed? So we have here, we have seen e power, and instead of negative, suppose you make it positive. Suppose you make it positive, it's going to x. Just try plotting e to the power of 80 instead of e power minus 80. Try plotting e power plus 80 and see what happens. It will be an exponentially increasing function. Please try that. Yes, so next function, we'll proceed. Now we'll try to plot, say, cosine wave. Say cosine and let us say sine wave in the same plot. So once again, let us say NP dot linspace 0 to 2. And let us say 50 values. And let me put my x1t as np dot cos 2 pi t. And let me put x2 of t as np dot sine 2 pi t, and let's try to plot both of them on the same curve. So plt dot plot t comma x1 t, and what is x1? The label this is cos 2 pi t. And what is my next function? Plt dot plot t comma x2 t. And what's the label? Sine 2 pi t. Next. We normally like to have the grid on, and we want the legend to be displayed. So plt dot, and you want to give an x label, or you want to put a title. Title you put as sinusoidal signals, and please run it and tell me if you are able to get it. What is it we are getting now? So we are trying to plot sine and cosine signal in a plot. Let's run it. Oh, what's the mistake? I cannot put, I need to put np dot pi. Yes. And this is also np dot pi. because pi, I need, it's defined in numpy, and hence I need to put np dot pi. Yes, did you try it? And have you got the result? And in this case, it has displayed the legend here. So we have the blue color being the cosine function, the orange color being the sine function, and this is what we have. Are you doing it? Yes, okay. Next function, let's take again sinusoidal only, but let me copy. Let me copy the signal, I mean this cell. And again, it's plotting of cosine waves of different frequency. So I want to have both of them as cos. One is say 2 pi t, another is say, 4 pi t. So I'm changing the frequency. So please check this. So I have copied the cell. I'm trying to plot cos 2 pi t, cos 4 pi t. So one of them is cos 2 pi t, the other is cos 4 pi t. And I'm plotting it in the same interval 0 to 2. So please run this and see whether we get the result. So do you see the cosine function, the original cosine function of frequency? What's the frequency of the blue color cosine wave? Can someone tell me what is the frequency of the blue color cosine wave? Yes. And the second waveform is of frequency 2. The first signal has a frequency 1. And the second signal has a frequency 2. I need feedback. Am I going fast or you're able to do it? I will go slow. I will repeat. You want me to show the program? Yes, are we done? Can we proceed? Can we proceed? Are you all trying? Okay. Vivek says it's a bit fast. Okay, I will try to go slow. Okay. Yes. Okay, so we will take up one more function now. Let us try to plot. Plot an exponential function. Let's do an if statement. An if statement. An if statement. If statement to display grade, say given the marks. If just for learning, let us say marks is say 45. Marks is 45, and I want to display the grade. It's completely different from plotting, but let's do an marks is 45. A student got and then we want to learn to use the if statement. So what we'll have is say if marks is less than 40, normally what's the grade we get? Print. Grade is F. Your elf has this. And what is it? If marks marks less than 40. And let us say if marks is greater than or equal to 40, then let us print the letter grade. Print. Say grade is pass. Just try if this works. So now I am giving my marks as 45 and I'm trying to use the if statement. So let's run and see whether it works. Please try this. Because we want to use the if statement for plotting an exponential function. When t is less than 0, I want to give it 0. When t is greater than 0, I want to give something else. That's the reason. Let's get introduced to the if statement. Note the command here. If, and what's my condition? If marks is less than 40. And please remember to terminate it with a colon. And all commands after an indent gets executed, then elif here greater than or equal to 40, I get a pass. Please let me know if you have completed this. Okay. So now let us put some more grades. If the marks lie between 40 and 60, let us say we give a B grade and 60 to 80 A grade and so on. So let's try to do that. So this is one. Let's repeat it. But now we will put some more grades. So greater than or equal to 40. And marks is less than 60. Then we will print the grade as, let us say B grade. B grade. Elif marks is greater than or equal to 60. And marks is less than 80. Let us print the grade as A and elif marks is greater than or equal to 80. We will print the grade as an S. See whether it works. So now with 45 marks, it is supposed to display a B grade. Let us check with 85 marks. I should get an S grade. Just try this. So multiple conditions for marks. So here we have just one line. All the lines with under a common indent will work. Please remember, I have given double indent. By default, it will give a single indent. So two tabs. So it looks clear, like what are the commands getting executed for each condition. Please let me know if this has worked. Can I proceed? Yes, so now let's take another. Now let's take one more. Let us, this will be building an array. Let us try to build an array. Let us say A is null. And let us say for n in range 10. A dot append n. Print A. Please tell me what are you getting? Please let me know what are you getting. And what is the output? We are trying to build an array. This should be A equal to. I am defining an empty array. And then we have seen the for loop yesterday. For n in range. What happens for n in range? It executes from 0 to 9. And every time I'm running the loop, and it is prep. I need someone to explain what is happening in this command. Or you want to print A in every loop. Let's run this and see what happens. See what happened in the first time when it went inside the for loop. A was empty. So we have A as empty. The next time in the for loop, what's the value of A? We saw this command yesterday. This is a command which is going to run from 0 to 2, 0 to 9. So A becomes 0. So now the value of A is added, the value of N, which is 0, is added to the array A. So that is 0. Next run of the for loop, N becomes 1. So then this is building an array. We are building an array and finally when it comes out, it is having the value 0 to 9. Of course, why did we do this? We could have simply done for A in np.range, I would have got it. But here we want to know how to build an array element by element. Just to learn that we are trying to have the same command. This is having the same command as another method for A equal to np dot A range 10. Same value. See here, now suppose I put B equal to np dot A range 10 and let us say print B. I have the same result, but the contents are obtained in a different manner. So I will delete all this. So yes. So this is just to see how to build an array. Now we have seen if statement. We have seen building an array. Now let us try to plot the exponential function. Once again, we will try to plot the exponential function. But this time, my time will not go from 0 to 5, but it will go from, say, minus 2 to this. So now let us take. So whenever t is less than 0, I want my signal to be 0. And if t is greater than 0, I want it to be the exponential function. So now let me define my time. T is np dot dot win space. Let us say minus 2 to 5 and let us say I take 50 value. So this is my time. I'm defining my time in the interval minus 2 to 5 and 50 values. And then what I will do, my A, so now for, okay, let me call this as for n is equal to 50. N is 50 for n in range n. So this loop is going to run for 50 times 0 to 49. And how do I access the element? Now my condition is if time is less than 0, then my signal, let me first define my signal x of t. Xt is a null signal. What's my value of the signal? Let's say the value is 0. Because whenever t is less than 0, my value of the signal is 0. Else if, what is my value of the signal? My value of the signal is going to be np dot exponential minus let us say 0.3 into t. And what is my t of n? And now I have computed the value. So I'm giving the value 0 if t is less than 0. I'm giving the value e power minus at. And I can define a. Let us say that becomes easier. A is equal to say 0.3. So this is e power minus at. And then I need to append my array. What is my signal? Xt. Xt dot, I'm building the array. And what should I put it here now? I want my array to be added with the value. What should I put here? The value. I'm appending my array with the value. Now let me plot. PLT dot plot t comma xt. T comma xt. And let us see whether it works. Hope it works. Oh. Yes, I need to. So if you see here, else, okay, okay, yes, okay, he said yes, okay, let's check, yeah, so this was, thank you, Shashank. So else or elif, and yes, the last one is else, and this is what we get. So this here we have, and you, is it 0 for t less than 0 and e power minus 80 for t greater than 0, but the transition is not so sharp. If I want the transition to be sharp, let me just make the number of terms as larger, and so this is what we have. So now let's run it. And this is what I have, my exponential function. It is plotting only till 5. I wanted to plot for a greater number of values. It goes up to 10. So I wanted to decay better. So I go up to 10. So is it clear? Have you tried this? So here we are trying to put a for loop and an if statement inside the for loop. An if statement inside the for loop. Yes, anyway, the code will be shared so you can try it out. So let's take another example. I said we will see something interesting with sine and cos. So let us do the take up the example of cos a plus b. Cos a plus b, what did we say it is? Cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. So let's do this. Now here we are going to take something different. What I'll do is first let us define time. Time is np dot dot linspace 0 comma 2 comma say 500. Now let me put f1 is some frequency. F1 is say 10, and let me have another frequency f2. F2 is say 1. F2 is say 1. And then I will have my a. What is a? 2 pi. 2 pi. F1 t. So I am defining one frequency f1, and I am calling defining my a as 2 pi f1 t. And then b. What is b? 2 pi. F2 t, 2 pi f2 t. So this is what we have. Now let us try to plot this whole function, and please tell me what you are observing. Please let me know what you are observing. So what is my signal xt now? Xt is going to be cos a, cos b, np dot cos b minus np dot sin a into np dot sin b. And then plot plt dot plot t comma xt. Please try this. Let's hope. And see what you're getting. What's the result we get? I am plotting. I am having two signals, f1 and f2. And I am defining my a as 2 pi f1 t, b as 2 pi f2 t, and then cos a cos b minus sin a sin b. That's all I have done. And I'm trying to plot t versus xt. Please run this and tell me what's the result you're getting. Please run this and explain the answer. Please try it out, and you will see something extremely interesting. Did anyone complete this? What did you get? Yes. Can you tell me what is the yes, Shashank has replied he has got it. Has anyone else tried it? Please try. I mean, don't think that cosine plus b we did in our high school and why are we doing it now? No, please don't have that opinion. Let's run it and then see what we are getting. What have we got? Yes. Can someone tell me what is the frequency of this waveform that we have got? What is the frequency of the waveform that we have got? We have taken two frequencies, F1 and F2. What is the frequency of the frequency? Yes. So what's the frequency? If you want, it becomes easy if I, instead of defining my time as 0 to 2, let me define my time as 0 to 1 so that I can compute the frequency easily. Let me run the code. I've just changed my time. Instead of 0 to 2, I made it 0 to 1. And now count, what is the frequency? How many peaks are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 cycles. So we have got a sine cosine wave of frequency 11. So should I put it here? Result is cosine of frequency 11. And what is 11? F1 plus F2. F1 plus F2. Now just change it. Instead of a minus sign, if I make it as plus sign, what will I get? Let's run it and see. I will get a frequency of. Can someone tell me if I make this as plus, how much is the frequency now? At 9. Very good, very good. So I will retain this as minus. And when I have a minus sign, I have a frequency of plus. On the other hand, if I do cos A minus B, I think we will copy the whole cell. And then we will have here, this is, let us say, cos A minus B, and then I will put a plus. And now I'm going to get a signal of frequency 9, which is frequency F1 minus F2. And then I run it. This is what I have. And for those who have completed higher semesters, will recognize this waveform as the upper side band and the lower side band in communication. And let's take up one more very similar example. Now what we will do is we will take up. Now here I will write my waveform as the product of two sine waves that results in, for example, the DSBSC waveform. So here, all that I'm going to do is I have cosine, sine, this and this, and now I will plot. I will just plot the product. I have cos A and cos B, and let me plot, or let me change it as a sine. Either way, no problem. So let me run it here, and this is our double sideband suppressed carrier. So we can put the title as PLT dot title the DSB SC waveform. This is just an example. We are not, If you have not done communication, no problem. This is just to see, because we do have a few students from the electronics and other other streams. So we are just doing in time domain. We have just learned to define time and to plot functions and see how many results we are able to see. We will just make a small change in this program only, and you will be able to see the AM waveform. Let us see the AM amplitude modulated waveform product plus addition of signal. And here what happens, I am going to have np dot cos a and then multiplied and plus and let us say 0.5. Let's look at this. So we have let me just make the time a little bigger, say 0 to 2. See, we have a beautiful amplitude modulated waveform. Has anyone come across AM modulation? Do we have students who have come to the third year? And you will be able to recognize this AM waveform, and similarly the earlier one. Otherwise, no problem. In analog signal processing, we don't need this. Just to compare the DSB and this, I can make this as so both are in the same time. So this is a DSB and this is the AM waveform, and here we had the USB. If I want to put a title here, PLT dot title, and this is the single sideband. So this was just to see the power of cos A and adding, and then how we have such other signals that have relevance earlier later. Okay, now we were to plot, I think, the sync function. Let us plot the sync function. Let us plot the sync function. And what is the sync function? Sine x by x, which is nothing but sine x by x. So once again, let us define our time, np dot linspace. Let us say minus 3 to 3, and let us say we have some 100 values in the interval minus 3 to 3, and what is my A? My A is say 2 into np dot pi into t, and then what is my xg? Xg is say sine x by x, so np dot sine a divided by a, and I need to just plot it, plt dot plot t comma xt. Is it fine? Please try and see whether you're getting the sync function. We have seen what is the sync function. We have learned to plot the sync function in the theory class. Please see whether you're getting the expected plot. Please see whether we are getting the expected plot. The sync function. The sync function, which takes a value 1 at t equal to 0, and the sine function, which keeps decreasing as time increases. So let me run. Okay, good. So let's run this and see. And this is what we have. We get the sync function. So now just change it, and not showing at t equal to 0. Yes, I'll explain to you why. Now you just change that to 100, and then now it shows that t equal to 0. The reason is, in case our time had a 0, 0/0 comes into picture, and then probably it had some problem. So to avoid that zero, we just make a change here. And then so now when I look at my time, I will not have that. So let just to get convinced, let us define t equal to np dot dot linspace. Let us say -3 to 3, and let us say 10 values, and let me print print t. And are we yeah, okay. Yes, so if you need to be careful and try to avoid the zero, then it will plot. Now just try changing the frequency. Instead of 2 pi t, please try putting just pi t. And then now run the function and see what happens. Instead of 2 pi t, now we are running it at pi t. And then see what happens. Earlier we had a zero crossing somewhere, and then now we have a zero crossing somewhere else. So it has got expanded, because instead of a being pi t, I had to you can play around and see whether the zero crossings are matching with what we had done in the theory. So this is the sync function. Let's put a title also for this. Yes, so you can try plotting. You can plot two functions on the same curve. You know how to do that. Let's take one more example. And what's the next example? Let's try to plot the hyperbolic function. The cos hyperbolic function. So now here, normally we take x, let us say x equal to np dot dot linspace, let us say -3 to 3, and let us say some 50 values, and now let me call a as say np dot exp of x, and let me call b as np dot exp of minus x. And then now suppose I want to plot cos hyperbolic function. Let me call this, let's say fx. What should I do now? How do I represent cos hyperbolic function? What is cos hyperbolic function? E to the power of x plus e to the power of minus x divided by 2. Do we agree to that? So if I have this as the definition, so I have a plus b by 2. And then if I want to plot it, plt dot plot x comma fx. Please check. Tell me, are you getting the plot? E power x plus e power minus x by 2, and I'm defining my x in the range -3 to +3. And because hyperbolic functions we come across in different courses, and it's good to know how it looks like. And what's the title I will give this? Plt dot dot title. I'll give the title as cos hyperbolic of x. Are you getting it? Yes. Cosine hyperbolic. Very good. So see, in mathematics or in other courses, you will come across it. And when we look at the curve, it feels so good that we are able to plot it ourselves. Now, similarly, let us do the sine hyperbolic function. Please do the sine hyperbolic function. So now we will call this as sine hyperbolic function, and that is just a minus sign. And so this will be a minus b by 2, and the title will be sine hyperbolic. Please try plotting the sine hyperbolic function. And then we realize that it is not so complicated. It's not so complicated, and it is so simple when we have a code with which we can plot. Please run this and see whether it works. Let's plot it. And do we get this? You can. It's always good to put the grid so that it's nice to see the curve. Yes. And the next function we'll try to plot is the tan hyperbolic. So let's plot another function. This I want everyone to plot, the tan hyperbolic function, which is e power x plus e power minus. No, there's a minus. And a plus, so this will be a minus b by a plus b. A plus b, plot this, and what is my title now? Tan hyperbolic x. Just plot this, and let us also have the grid. Did you get this curve? And all those who are doing computer science and who are doing data science will recognize that this tan hyperbolic function is used in your analytics. Tan hyperbolic is one of the activation functions for the neurons. So you will appreciate this curve. See, it goes from minus 1 to 1 to plus 1, minus 1 to plus 1. Please let me know if you have got this result, the plot of the tan hyperbolic function. You want me to put the code? I can put the code. You can have a look at it. Yes. Yes. So then there's one more function, the sigmoid function. Let's do that as well. Let's do that as well, the sigmoid function. Yes. So now let's plot another one. The sigmoid. Yeah, let's take the same. I'll just copy and paste, and then I will try to I try to plot now my sigmoid function. These are all just functions, and this is very simple. This is 1 by 1 by 1. Plus e power minus x. So this is simpler than the earlier functions. So I don't even need a b here. I need only a, and f of x is 1 divided by 1 plus a. And what's my title? My title is a sigmoid function. And please try this. And plot, let's plot it and see what you get now. What are the limits of fx? Please let me know the limits of f of x. Does it go from minus 1 to 1 or 0 to 1 or 1 to 2? Please let me know the limits of f of x. What are the limits? F of x goes from what range to what range? No, it's come. Sorry, it is a is e power minus x. Sorry, a is e power minus x. Yes, it goes in this manner. You are not able to see the limits, so let me make it say from minus 5 to plus 5. And let us look at it. The function goes see it goes from 0 to 1. Again, this is a function used, we come across often, and it mostly used in computer science engineers will be using this function often, the sigmoid function. So let's try to plot another one more function which we need often. Let us say the Gaussian distribution function. Because as engineers, we come across the Gaussian function so many places that it's good to know how it looks like. Let us say mu is say 2, and let us say sigma is say 1, what is my function? If you remember the function, it is f of x is 1 by sigma square root of 2 pi, and then e to the power of minus x minus mu whole square, and then divided by 2 sigma square. So this is the function. let me define a constant a. Let us say a, that is 1 by sigma divided by square root. So np dot, again it's square root is a function defined in the NumPy library. So np dot square root 2 pi. So 2 into np dot pi. This is my constant a. And let me call b as say e to the power of. So np dot e to the power of minus x minus mu whole square. Whole square, and this is divided by two, so let me make it as 0.5 into x minus mu whole square by sigma square. So what is that? By sigma divided by sigma, and my final function f of x is nothing but a into b. And let me try plotting plt dot plot x comma fx. Let us check whether it works. So we have defined a mu, we have defined a sigma, and my constant a is 1 by sigma square root of 2 pi, and my e to the power of minus x minus mu whole square divided by 2 sigma square, and let's run it and see whether we get the result. And this is what we have. What is the mean? We have put a mean as 2 and we put a sigma as 1. You just play around with mu and sigma, make mu as 0 and see what happens. PLT dot grid. Grid plt dot title the Gaussian distribution function. So let's run it. So I put a mean. This is the usual distribution. When we say a normalized distribution, as it's normalized, so we make the mean as 0 and standard deviation as 1, and 3 sigma limits, we say minus 3 sigma to plus 3 sigma, most of the signal is present, and 5 sigma it is 0. Again, this Gaussian function has lot of application. Now suppose I change my sigma to 2, what is happening now? Let us see. I retain my mean as 0 and make my sigma as 2. What has happened? it has got spread. It has got spread out because my sigma has increased. If I make my sigma less, let us say I make my sigma as 0.3, I'm running it with a sigma of 0.3, then what happens? What happens? It has become narrower. It has become narrower. So I'm retaining the mu, but I'm changing the sigma. So let me keep my sigma as say 0.8. Sorry, let me make my mean as say 3. So what happens now? When I run it, the whole distribution has got moved towards the mean of 3. So try plotting 2 or 3 distributions on the same curve and give a suitable ligand. So this is the Gaussian distribution function. So did we miss out anything? Are we supposed to plot something else? Have we tried plotting all the functions that we had discussed in the theory? Is there some more functions? Yes. So I think we can stop here. Any questions? Any questions? I know few of you were able to catch up and have been able to do. Some of you might have been a little bit slow. The whole program will be shared. So please practice it. Please practice and try doing some more functions. Just with the plot function, you can plot so many more functions. Please try plotting them and observing. Please try plotting and observing. Yes, any more questions? So can we stop here? So we stop here. Tomorrow we'll continue. We'll define a subfunction and try to do integration and differentiation. Of course, you may be wondering why do we do integration and differentiation, but yes, it's required, it's important, we need to do it. We need to do it because again we come across these operations so often in so many courses. So thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.